राम 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 सुप्रभातम सर्वेभ्यः हृत्पूर्वक नमस्काराः वेलकम टू श्री वेंकटेश्वर सुप्रभातम पारायण शिक्षण वेबिनार वेर वी आर लर्निंग टू चैंट श्री वेंकटेश्वर सुप्रभातम सो एज यू ऑल नो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द फर्स्ट 20 वर्सेस ऑफ श्री वेंकटेश्वर सुप्रभातम दैट इज द फर्स्ट कॉम्पोनेंट And we have around 9 more verses left. So let us see if we can complete those today. Otherwise, maybe we can definitely complete by tomorrow. So after that, we will have some time for individual chanting. So please practice. Mostly in tomorrow's class, there'll be some time for individual chanting. Then we will move to learning Shri Venkateshwara Stotram. Let us begin as usual with Guru Vandanam and a quick recap of the verses we learnt in yesterday's class. Guru Reva Gatir Guru Meva Bhaje Guru Naiva Sahasminamo Gurave न गुरोः परमं शिशुरस्मि गुरोः मतिरस्ति गुरौ मम पाहि गुरो verses 15 to 20 I will just chant the first verse and then move to the 16th verse कौसल्या सुप्रजा राम पूर्वा संध्या प्रवर्तते उत्तिष्ठ नरशार्दूल कर्तव्यं दैवमान्हिकम् verse 16 which we learned yesterday सेवा परा शिव सुरेश कृशानु धर्म रक्षोम्बुनाथ पवमान धनाधिनाथाः बद्धांजलि प्रविलसन्निज शीर्षरेशाः श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम् धाटीशुते विहगराज मृगाधिराज नागाधिराज गजराज हयाधिराजाः स्वस्वाधिकार महिमादिकमर्थयन्ते श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम् सूर्येन्दुभौम बुधवाक्पति काव्य सौरिस्वर्भानुकेतु दिविशत् परिषत् प्रधानाः त्वद्दास दास चरमावधि दास दासाः श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम् त्वत्पादधूलिभरितस्फुरितोत्तमाङ्गाः स्वर्गापवर्गनिरपेक्षनिजान्तरङ्गाः कल्पागमाकलनयाकुलताल्लभन्ते श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम् त्वद्गोपुराग्रशिखराणि निरीक्षमाणाः स्वर्गापवर्गपदवीं परमां श्रयन्तः मर्त्या मनुष्यभुवने मतिमाश्रयन्ते श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम् Yes, now we will begin with the 21st verse. Vibha, please unmute and share your webcam.
Ram Ram Ram.
Ram Ram Ram. श्री भूमि नायक
श्रीभूमिनायक दयादिगुणामृताब्धे दयादिगुणामृताब्धे
देवादिदेव
देवादिदेव देवादिदेव जगदेक शरण्यमूर्ते जगदेक शरण्यमूर्ते
श्रीमन्ननंत
श्रीमन्ननंत श्रीमन्ननंत
गरुडादिभिरर्चिताङ्घ्रे
गरुडादिभिरर्चिताङ्घ्रे गरुडादिभिरर्चिताङ्घ्रे
श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम् श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
ओके द महाप्राणास् हियर् श्रीभूमिनायक भ इस् महाप्राण दयादिगुणामृताब्धे धे इज महाप्राण देवादिदेव जगदेक शरण्यमूर्ते श्रीमन्ननंत गरुडादिभिरर्चिताङ्घ्रे प्लीज नोट दिस वर्ड क्लियरली गरुडादिभिः अर्चिताङ्घ्रे व्हेन यू स्प्लिट गरुडादिभिरर्चिताङ्घ्रे भी एंड घ हियर घ्रे इज महाप्राण प्लीज रिमेंबर द घोषा कॉन्सेप्ट व्हिच वी लर्नड यस्टरडे फॉर ऑल द fourth letters of each varga. So here for bhu, dha, bhi, gha, bha, everywhere you get ghosha concept. Shri Venkatachalapate tava suprabhatam. We will repeat. Shri Bhuminayaka dayadi gunamritabdhe.
श्रीभूमिनायक दयादिगुणामृताब्धे श्रीभूमिनायक दयादिगुणामृताब्धे
देवादिदेव जगदेक शरण्यमूर्ते
देवादिदेव जगदेक शरण्यमूर्ते देवादिदेव जगदेक शरण्यमूर्ते
श्रीमन्ननंत गरुडादिभिरर्चिताङ्घ्रे
श्रीमन्ननंत गरुडादिभिरर्चिताङ्घ्रे श्रीमन्ननंत गरुडादिभिरर्चिताङ्घ्रे
श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम् श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
नौ दि एण्टैर् वर्स्
श्रीभूमिनायक दयादिगुणामृताब्धे देवादिदेव जगदेक शरण्यमूर्ते श्रीमन्ननंत गरुडादिभिरर्चिताङ्घ्रे श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
श्रीभूमिनायक दयादिगुणामृताब्धे देवादिदेव जगदेक शरण्यमूर्ते श्रीमन्ननन्त गरुडादिभिरर्चिताङ्घ्रे श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्।
Tamam Vibha. Before we move to the next verse, here please note the pronunciation of this word Amrita. We come across this word in many Sanskritam texts, many verses. It is not Amritam. There is no extra m there. That is a very common error to recite it or to pronounce it as Amritam. It is not Amritam. It is Amritam. There is no Samyuktakshara there. This is just a Gunitaksharam. M plus R. So it is like Krishnaha, Kripa, that way. So it is Amritam. Here, Dayadi Gunamritabdhe. Please do not chant it as Gunamritabdhe. There is no extra M there. Please note that Amritam, that word has to be pronounced just as a, that Mr has to be pronounced as a Gunitaksharam, not with an extra M behind it. So Dayadi Gunamritabdhe. I hope that's clear. Next verse. Shivani.
Shri Padmanabha Purushottama Vasudeva.
Shri Padmanabha Purushottama Vasudeva. श्री पद्मनाभ पुरुषोत्तम वासुदेव वैकुंठ माधव
जनार्दन चक्रपाणे
जनार्दन चक्रपाणे श्रीवत्सचिह्न
शरणागत पारिजात
श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्।
ओके, सो हियर प्लीज नोट द महाप्राणाः Shri Padmanabha. So all these you all would have found out by now. All these are just the names of Bhagavan, different names addressing Bhagavan Venkateshwara by different names. So Shri Padmanabha, Bha is Mahaprana, Purushottama, Vasudeva, Vaikuntha, Madhava, Tha is Mahaprana in Vaikuntha, Madhava, Dha is Mahaprana, जनार्दन चक्रपाणे श्रीवत्सचिह्न शरणागत पारिजात श्रीवेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्। हियर प्लीज नोट द प्रोनाउंसिएशन श्री पद्मनाभ। इट इज नॉट पद्म, इट इज नॉट त, सो प्लीज बी वेरी केयरफुल। इट इज पद्मनाभ नॉट त, द, सो दैट डिफरेंसिएशन बिटवीन त द K, G, P, B should be extremely clear. They are different letters. They are not the same letter. So please do not interchange while pronouncing these. T, D, P, B, K, G. Now we will repeat.
Shri Padmanabha Purushottama Vasudeva Vaikuntha Madhava Janardana Chakra
श्रीपद्मनाभपुरुषोत्तमवासुदेव वैकुण्ठमाधव जनार्दन चक्रपाणे श्री पद्मनाभ पुरुषोत्तम वासुदेव वैकुंठ माधव जनार्दन चक्रपाणे
श्रीवत्स चिन्ह शरणागत पारिजात श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
श्रीवत्स चिन्ह शरणागत पारिजात श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम् श्रीवत्स चिन्ह शरणागत पारिजात श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
Tamam here, Vasudeva, Sharanagata Parijata, they are all short letters, Hraswa, not Dirgha letters, not long letters. So now let us chant the entire verse.
Shri Padmanabha Purushottama Vasudeva, Vaikuntha Madhava Janardana Chakrapane, श्रीवत्स चिन्ह शरणागत पारिजात श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
श्री पद्मनाभ पुरुषोत्तम वासुदेव वैकुंठ माधव जनार्दन चक्रपाणे श्रीवत्स चिन्ह शरणागत पारिजात श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
वर्ड हियर इट इज श्रीवत्स चिन्ह इट इज नॉट चिह्न वी डू नॉट प्रोनाउंस इट एज चिह्न आई हैव रिपीटेड दिस इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस अ फ्यू वर्ड्स इन संस्कृतम लाइक ब्रह्म हियर चिन्ह Madhyanhah, Janhavi. So these words, though we write as here, for example, it is ha and then nu here, but we pronounce it as Shrivatsa Chinha. We do not pronounce it as Shrivatsa Chihna. We do not pronounce it that way. Similarly, Brahma, we do not pronounce it as Brahma. Of late, recently, there are a few schools which are saying, actually very few, we have heard that some of them are told to pronounce it as Brahma and not as Brahma, but that is not what we learn here. We in Vyoma, we only pronounce it as Brahma, Shrivatsa Chinha, that way. And this is what our gurus have also taught us. And since certain rules, of course, even in Vedas, and Sanskritam is a very ancient language, like you all know, and by Guru Parampara, certain rules have been passed on. So this is one such. For such words, it is an exception. We do not pronounce it the way we write, but these are only a few exceptions, like I told you. This is one such. Shrivatsa Chinha. We do not pronounce it as Shrivatsa Chihna. So I hope that is clear. Next verse, Vibha.
Kandarpa darpa hara sundara divya murte.
Kandarpa darpa hara sundara divya murte. Kandarpa पदर्पहर सुंदर दिव्य मूर्ते
कांता कुचाम गुरुह कुट्मल लोल दृष्टे
कांता कुचाम गुरुह कुट्मल लोल दृष्टे कांता कुचाम गुरुह कुट्मल लोल दृष्टे
कल्याण निर्मल गुणाकर दिव्य कीर्ते
कल्याण निर्मल गुणाकर दिव्य कीर्ते कल्याण निर्मल गुणाकर दिव्य कीर्ते
श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम् श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
कंदर्प दर्प हर सुंदर दिव्य मूर्ते So here, please note Kandarpa Darpa. There, while chanting this, it should not be prolonged as Kandarpa Darpa. Sometimes that there is the tendency. Please do not prolong it like that. It is Kandarpa Darpa. It is a crisp r there in between the and pa. Kandarpa Darpa Hara Sundara Divya Murte Kanta Kuchamburuha Kutmala Lola Drishte. There is no split or pause here. The entire line should be chanted at a stretch. Please note every letter. Kanta kucham buruha kutmala lola drishte. Kalyana nirmala gunakara divya kirte. Shri Venkata chalapate tava suprabhatam. Bha as usual mahaprana. Now we will chant two lines at a time. Kandarpadar पहर सुंदर दिव्य मूर्ते कांता कुचांबुरुह कुटमल लोल दृष्टे
कंदर्प दर्प हर सुंदर दिव्य मूर्ते कांता कुचांबुरुह कुटमल लोल दृष्टे कंदर्प दर्प पहर सुंदर दिव्य मूर्ते कांता कुचांबुरुह कुट्मल लोल दृष्टे
कल्याण निर्मल गुणाकर दिव्य कीर्ते श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
कल्याण निर्मल गुणाकर दिव्य कीर्ते श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम् कल्याण निर्मल गुणाकर दिव्य कीर्ते श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
Now the entire verse together. Kandarpa darpa hara sundara divya murte Kanta kuchamburuha kutmala lola drishte Kalyana nirmala gunakara divya kirte Shri Venkata chalapate tava supa प्रभातम्
कंदर्प दर्प हर सुंदर दिव्य मूर्ते कांता कुचांबुरुह कुट्मल लोल दृष्टे कल्याण निर्मल गुणाकर दिव्य कीर्ते श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव Prabhatam.
So one query regarding how do we know the entire line should be chanted together. If you look at the Devanagari script here, Kanta Kuchamburuha Kutmala Lola Drishte, there is no split. If you see the entire word, there is just one line on top. Here, for example, Kandarpa Darpa Hara Sundara, there is a space here, and then Divya Murte. Similarly, even in the diacritical version, Kandarpa Darpa Hara Sundara, there is a space, then next word, Divya Murte. But if you see the next line, Kanta Kuchamburuha Kutmala Lola Drishte, it is together, there is no space. It is as simple as just reading different words in a text. You know that there will be a space typed between words. So if it is one word, there is no space. Here, Kalyana Nirmala Gunakara, space, Divya Murte. Whether you're looking at Sanskritam or English, in both there is a space. Shri Venkata Chalapate, this is the first word, space. Tava, there is space. Then Suprabhatam. So there is no need for us to give you a list of all lines which are to be chanted at a stretch. It is there in the script itself. So we just have to be careful in understanding that space between each word. And I told you that when the first line, second line have to be chanted together, there is a hyphen in the text. So that is an indication that both lines have to be chanted together. So I hope that's clear. We'll move to the next verse, Shivani.
Meena krite kamatha kola.
Meena krite kamatha kola. Meena krite kamatha kola.
Nrisimha varnin.
Nrisimha varnin. Nrisimha varnin.
Swamin parashvathata podhana.
Swamin parashvathata podhana. Swamin parashvathata podhana.
Ramachandra.
Ramachandra. Ramachandra.
Shesham sharamaya dunandana.
Shesham sharamaya dunandana. Shesham sharamaya dunandana.
Kalki roopa.
Kalki roopa. Kalki roopa.
Shri Venkatachalapate tava suprabhatam.
Shri Venkatachalapate tava suprabhatam. Shri Venkatachalapate tava suprabhatam.
Here you will notice that there are multiple words, again addressing Bhagavan in multiple names. Meena krite kamatha, tha is mahaprana, kola, nrisimha, please note pronunciation of this word also, nrisimha, nrisimha, nrisimha varnin. So this particular halanta which you see in the end, I am pointing to the Sanskritam version, this is called a halanta. It denotes that the last letter has to be chanted half. In Hindi, there is a rule that the last letters are always chanted half. But in Sanskritam, we do not follow that. For example, next line, Ramachandra. Wherever there is no halanta, then the entire letter has to be chanted. Only when there is this halanta, we chant the letter half. So, Varnin. Swamin, again here there is a halanta, therefore Swamin. If there is no halanta, we chant it as na. Because there is a halanta, we chant it as Swamin. Parashvatha, tha is mahaprana, please note pronunciation, Parashvatha. Tapodhana, dha is mahaprana. Ramachandra, Sheshamsha Rama, Yadunandana, Kalki Rupa, Shri Venkata Chalapate, tava suprabhatam.
Meena krite kamatha kola nrisimha varnin.
Meena krite kamatha kola nrisimha varnin. Meena krite kamatha kola nrisimha varnin.
Swamin parashvachata podhana Ramachandra.
Swamin parashvachata podhana Ramachandra. Swamin parashvachata podhana Ramachandra.
Sheshamsha Ramaya dunandana kalki roopa.
Shesham sharamaya dunandana kalki roopa. Shesham sharamaya dunandana kalki roopa.
श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम् श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
ओके नौ दि एण्टायर् वर्स्
मीनाकृते कमठकोलनृसिंहवर्णिन् स्वामिन् परश्वछतपोधन रामचन्द्र शेषांश राम यदुनन्दन कल्किरूप श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
मीनाकृते कमठकोलनृसिंहवर्णिन् स्वामिन् परश्वथतपोधन रामचन्द्र शेषांश राम यदुनन्दन कल्किरूप श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
What is Halanta is one question which I've been asked. This line which you see here, only if you look at the Sanskritam script, you will find the Halanta. If you're looking at English, there is no Halanta. It is just written as Varnin, I-N in the end. But if you're looking at Sanskritam, Devanagari, this line which you see below N, below Na, that is Halanta. Similarly, Swamin, that line which you see, that is a Halanta. And here, Suprabhatam. That line which you see below Ma, that is called a Halanta. It denotes that the last letter should be chanted half. And it is not chanted as here. It's not Varnina, it is Varnin. Unless there is a Halanta, we chant the letter completely. For example, if you see here, Kamatha, Kola, Drisimha, Tapodhana, Ramachandra. There is no Halanta in all these words. Therefore, the last letter is chanted completely. Also, this is mostly for those who have Hindi influence. When we chant words like Ramachandra, each letter should be chanted completely. It is not Ramchandra. That is one thing we see when you chant with another language influence. In Hindi, when you're reciting a Hindi script or reading Hindi, you could follow the rules of Hindi. But when we are reading a Sanskritam script, we follow the rules of this language. So any language, it's that way. So we do not say Ramachandra. It is Ramachandra. Kamatha Kola. Parashvatha. Sheshamsha Rama. Every letter is chanted completely. The reason being, when we say, for example, Ramachandra, this Ma in Rama is M plus A. It is a Gunitaksharam. So, M plus A gives us Ma and we chant that completely. Similarly, Cha, Ch plus A gives us Cha, Rama Chandra. So, each letter should be chanted clearly and completely. Next, Vibha.
Elalavangaghanasara.
एलालवङ्गघनसार एलालवङ्गघनसार
सुगन्धितीर्थम्
सुगन्धितीर्थम् सुगन्धितीर्थम्
दिव्यं वियत्सरिति
दिव्यं वियत्सरिति दिव्यं वियत्सरिति
हेमघटेषु पूर्णम्
हेमघटेषु पूर्णम् हेमघटेषु पूर्णम्
धृत्वाद्य
धृत्वाद्य धृत्वाद्य
वैदिकशिखामणय प्रहृष्टाः
वैदिकशिखामणयः प्रहृष्टाः वैदिकशिखामणयः प्रहृष्टाः
तिष्ठन्ति वेङ्कटपते
तिष्ठन्ति वेङ्कटपते तिष्ठन्ति वेङ्कटपते
तव सुप्रभातम्
तव सुप्रभातम् तव सुप्रभातम्
ओके लेट अस सी व्हाट द वर्ड्स आर एलालवंग घनसार सो हियर एलालवंग फर्स्ट घ इज अल्पप्राण सेकंड घ इज महाप्राण एलालवंग घनसार सुगंधि तीर्थम हियर धी इज महाप्राण तीर्थम ठ इज महाप्राण सो प्लीज डू नॉट इंटरचेंज हियर तीर्थम ओनली द सेकंड थ इज महाप्राण Here, elalavanga ghana. Only the second gha is mahaprana. First is alpaprana. This entire line should be chanted together. You see, there is no space. It's printed as one word. Elalavanga ghana sara sugandhi tirtham. Divyam viyat sariti hema ghateshu purnam. Gha is mahaprana. Dhritvadya. Dhr is here. Dha is mahaprana. वैदिक शिखामणयः प्रहृष्टाः हियर शिखा खा इज महाप्राण हियर विसर्ग फॉलोड बाय पा वी गेट व्हाट वी कॉल उपध्मानीय यू मस्ट हैव लर्नड इन द फर्स्ट टू क्लासेस सो वैदिक शिखामणयः प्रहृष्टाः व्हाइल चैंटिंग टुगेदर इंस्टेड ऑफ द विसर्ग वी चैंटेड एज वैदिक शिखामणय प्रहृष्टाः Next line, tishthanti, tha is mahaprana. Venkatapate, tava suprabhatam. Bha is also mahaprana here. I'll just indicate that. Tava suprabhatam. Bha is also mahaprana. Now we will repeat this verse. Elalavanga ghanasara sugandhi tirtham.
एलालवंग घनसार सुगंधि तीर्थम् एलालवंग घनसार सुगंधि तीर्थम्
दिव्यं वियत् सरिति हेम घटेषु पूर्णम्
दिव्यं वियत् सरिति हेम घटेषु पूर्णम् दिव्यं वियत् सरिति हेम घटेषु पूर्णम्
धृत्वाद्य वैदिक शिखामणय प्रहृष्टाः
धृत्वाद्य वैदिक शिखामणय प्रहृष्टाः धृत्वाद्य वैदिक शिखामणय प्रहृष्टाः
तिष्ठन्ति वेङ्कटपते तव सुप्रभातम्
तिष्ठन्ति वेङ्कटपते तव सुप्रभातम् तिष्ठन्ति वेङ्कटपते तव सुप्रभातम्
Now the entire verse. एलालवंग घनसार सुगंधि तीर्थम्
दिव्यं वियत् सरिति हेम घटेषु पूर्णम् धृत्वाद्य वैदिक शिखामणय प्रहृष्टाः तिष्ठन्ति वेङ्कटपते तव सुप्रभातम्
एलालवंग घनसार सुगंधि तीर्थम् दिव्यं वियत् सरिति हेम घटेषु पूर्णम् धृत्वाद्य वैदिक शिखामणय प्रहृष्टाः तिष्ठन्ति वेङ्कटपते तव सुप्रभातम्
उत्तमम् And we move to the next verse. Shivani.
भास्वानुदेति विकचानि सरोरुहाणि
भास्वानुदेति विकचानि सरोरुहाणि भास्वानुदेति विकचानि सरोरुहाणि
सम्पूरयन्ति निनदैः ककुभो विहङ्गाः
सम्पूरयन्ति निनदैः ककुभो विहङ्गाः सम्पूरयन्ति निनदैः ककुभो विहङ्गाः
श्रीवैष्णवाः सततमर्थितमङ्गलास्ते
श्रीवैष्णवाः सततमर्थितमङ्गलास्ते श्रीवैष्णवाः सततमर्थितमङ्गलास्ते
धामाश्रयन्ति तव वेङ्कटसुप्रभातम्
धामाश्रयन्ति तव वेङ्कटसुप्रभातम् धामाश्रयन्ति तव वेङ्कटसुप्रभातम्
So we will see which are the letters here. Mahapranaha. Bhasvanudeti. Bha is Mahaprana. Vikachani Saroruhani. So here please note Vikachani. This is ni. Whereas this is ni. So there is a difference. This belongs to Tatha Dadhana. That Varga. Ta Vargaha. This ni here belongs to Tatha Dadhana. That Vargaha. So again, we have to be very clear in pronouncing ni, and they should not be interchanged. So please note that. And also, it is a short letter, so not to be prolonged. Sampurayanti ninadaihi kakubho. Visarga followed by ka, it becomes jihva muliya. So ninadaihi kakubho. Instead of ninadaihi, the visarga completely, we chant it as Nina Daih Kakubho Vihangaha. Bho is Mahaprana. Shri Vaishnavas Satata Marthita Mangalaste. You see, this entire word is written together. That has to be chanted together. Shri Vaishnavas Satata Marthita Mangalaste. Dhamma Shrayanti. Dha is Mahaprana. Tava Venkata Suprabhatam. Dha is Mahaprana. Now we will repeat.
Bhasvanudeti vikachani saroruhani sampurayanti ninadaih kakubho vihangah.
Bhasvanudeti vikachani saroruhani sampurayanti ninadaih kakubho vihangah. भास्वानुदेति विकचानि सरोरुहाणि सम्पूरयन्ति निनदैः ककुभो विहङ्गाः
श्रीवैष्णवाः सततमर्थितमङ्गलास्ते धामाश्रयन्ति तव वेङ्कटसुप्रभातम्
श्री वैष्णवाः सततमर्थितमङ्गलास्ते धामाश्रयन्ति तव वेङ्कटसुप्रभातम् श्री वैष्णवाः सततमर्थितमङ्गलास्ते धामाश्रयन्ति तव वेङ्कटसुप्रभातम्
Now the entire verse.
भास्वानुदेति विकचानि सरोरुहाणि सम्पूरयन्ति निनदैः ककुभो विहङ्गाः श्रीवैष्णवाः सततमर्थितमङ्गलास्ते धामाश्रयन्ति तव वेङ्कटसुप्रभातम्
भास्वानुदेति विकचानि सरोरुहाणि सम्पूरयन्ति निनदैक कुभो विहङ्गाः श्रीवैष्णवा सततमर्थितमङ्गलास्ते धामाश्रयन्ति तव वेङ्कटसुप्रभातम्.
उत्तमम्. Here, there is a question, how to pronounce Mangalaste. It is Mangalaste as it is written itself. Mangalaste. This La is a Dirgha. Mangalaste is how we pronounce it. I hope that's clear. Next verse, Vibha.
Brahmadayas. सुरवरासमहर्षयस्ते
ब्रह्मादयः सुरवरासमहर्षयस्ते ब्रह्मादयः सुरवरासमहर्षयस्ते
सन्तस्सनन्दनमुखास्त्वच
सन्तस्सनन्दनमुखास्त्वथ सन्तस्सनन्दनमुखास्त्वथ
योगिवर्याः
योगिवर्याः योगिवर्याः
धामान्तिके तव हि
धामान्तिके तव हि धामान्तिके तव हि
मङ्गलवस्तु हस्ताः
मङ्गलवस्तु हस्ताः मङ्गलवस्तु हस्ताः
श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम् श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्
इस् नाट् ब्रह्मादयः सुरवरास्समहर्षयस्ते सो विसर्ग फालोड् बै सा वि गेट् वाट् वि काल् अ विसर्ग सकार सन्धि सो ब्रह्मादयः सुरवरास्समहर्षयस्ते Many sirs in this line, please be very careful to chant each of them correctly. Brahmadayas Suravarasa Maharshayaste. Two sirs here. Maharshayaste. Please note the pronunciation. Some of you have said it is a mistake in English, even in Chinha, because it was given as C-H-I-H-N-A. There is no mistake. That is how it is indicated in English also. Even in Sanskritam, if you see, we write ha and ma. But like I was telling you, this is one word where we pronounce it as Brahma. Similarly, even in diacritics in English, though it is written as HMA, we pronounce it as Brahmadayah. There are certain rules to indicate Sanskritam words or words of any other language in a different language, the rules of diacritics. So that is what is followed here when we give you the English script of Sanskritam. So even if you take any other authentic English script or diacritics, any other work, Brahma would be written as B-R-A-H-M-A, not B-R-A-M-H-A. Similarly, Chinha, etc. The way it is written in Sanskritam, the same way it is written in English also. It would be C-H-I-H-N-A, not N-H-A. But that is how we pronounce it as Chinha, Madhyanha, Brahma. So there is no mistake. These are the words you should remember that we pronounce as Brahma, though we write ha and ma. This the same rule applies to Sanskritam and to diacritics version also. Brahmadayas Suravarasa Maharshayaste Santasanandana Mukhastvatha. Please note this word clearly. Some scripts have Mukhastava, but we do not follow that script. We follow this. Santasanandana Mukhastvatha. Kha is Mahaprana. Tha is Mahaprana here. Yogi Varyaha. धामांतिके ध इज महाप्राण तव ही मंगल वस्तु हस्ताः श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्. नाउ लेट अस लर्न टू लाइन्स एट अ टाइम.
ब्रह्मादय सुरवरास समहर्षयस्ते संतसनंदन मुखास्त्वचयोगी वर्ग्याः.
ब्रह्मादय सुरवरास समहर्षयस्ते संतसनंदन मुखास्त्वचयोगी वर्ग्याः. ब्रह्मादय सुरवरास समहर्षयस्ते संतसनंदन मुखास्त्वचयोगी वर्ग्याः.
धामांतिके तव हि मंगल वस्तु हस्ताः श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्.
धामांतिके तव हि मंगल वस्तु हस्ताः श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्. धामांतिके तव हि मंगल वस्तु हस्ताः श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्.
Now the entire verse. Brahmadaya suravara samaharshayaste santasanandana mukhastvachayogi varyaha dhamantike tavahi mangalavastu hastaha shri venkatachalapate tavasu प्रभातम्.
ब्रह्मादय सुरवरास समहर्षयस्ते संतसनंदन मुखास्त्वथ योगी वर्याः धामांतिके तव हि मंगल वस्तु हस्ताः श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सु Prabhatam.
Tamam. We have just two more verses to go to finish Suprabhatam. That is Lakshmi Nivasa and Itham. We will learn those tomorrow. We will quickly recap the ones we have learned today. And for tomorrow, in all likelihood, there will be time for individual chanting. So please practice. You could raise your hand and I will unmute individually. And you could chant individually. So that we will have for tomorrow. Now let us recap the verses we have learned today.
Shri Bhumi Nayaka Dayadi Gunamritabdhe Devadi Deva Jagadeka Sharanya Murte श्रीमन्ननंत गरुडादिभिरर्चिताङ्घ्रे श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्. श्रीपद्मनाभ पुरुषोत्तम वासुदेव वैकुंठ माधव जनार्दन चक्रपाणे श्रीवत्स चिह्न शरणागत पारिजात श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्. कंदर्प दर्प हर सुंदर दिव्य मूर्ते कांता कुचांबुरुह कुट्मल लोल दृष्टे कल्याण निर्मल गुणाकर दिव्य कीर्ते श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्. मीनाकृते कमठकोल नृसिंह वर्णिन् स्वामिन् परश्वथ तपोधन रामचंद्र शेषांश रामयदुनंद नंदन कल्की रूप श्री वेंकटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्। एलालवंग घनसार सुगंधि तीर्थम् दिव्यं वियत्सरिति हेम घटेषु पूर्णम् धृत्वाद्य वैदिक शिखामणय प्रहृष्टाः तिष्ठन्ति वेंकटपते तव सुप्रभातम्। भास्वानुदेति विकचानि सरोरुहाणि सम्पूरयन्ति निनदैः ककुभो विहङ्गाः श्रीवैष्णवाः सततमर्चितमङ्गलास्ते धामाश्रयन्ति तव वेङ्कटसुप्रभातम्। ब्रह्मादयः सुरवराः समहर्षयस्ते सन्तः सनन्दनमुखास्त्वचयोगिवर्याः धामान्तिके तव हि मङ्गलवस्तुहस्ताः श्रीवेङ्कटाचलपते तव सुप्रभातम्।
So I hope these verses are clear to you. I will take some of the questions. Any questions, please type in the chat column, because individually unmuting everyone will take time and I will not be able to answer many questions. So if you type it out, it would be easier. One of you have asked me the same thing which many of you had a question about on when we can chant Suprabhatam. This was dealt with in detail in yesterday's class. So if you've missed yesterday's class, please go back to the recording. And there are recordings uploaded on YouTube and on the course page every day. Some of you were saying they have not been uploaded, but we have checked yesterday that all the recordings so far have been uploaded and it's up to date. Today's also will be uploaded in due course. And if I'm not wrong, it has also been on YouTube live, so the recording will be available. On the question when we can chant Suprabhatam, you're learning from a different time zone. Like I said yesterday, for Adhyayana, that is for learning, the common view is that there is no bar on the time when you learn. Basically, whenever the person teaching you is offering, for you, we are offering this course at this time. So the common view is that there is no bar on learning at any time. So for Adhyayana, there is no bar. For Upasana, or for your individual chanting, Parayanam, I have already explained yesterday. It is up to you, whatever you deem fit. More on this I have spoken in yesterday's class, so we are not going to repeat that today. When do we have the assessment? It would be at the end of the course. After we complete entire Suprabhatam, maybe in 2 weeks or 3 weeks, we will have the assessment. Okay, one of you, you've said that you've joined from Malaysia. The recordings are available. Please go to YouTube or to the course page and the recordings are uploaded there. And you could download the text also. Two avagraha mean two dirgha? No. Avagraha chinha does not mean dirgha, like I explained in previous classes. It just means that there is a purva rupa sandhi. It does not mean that there is a dirgha there. Meaning of tishthanti. Okay, tishthati in Sanskritam means stands. Tishthati, tishthataha, tishthanti. Tishthati is stands. Tishthanti is stand. As in, for plural we say tishthanti. For singular we say tishthati. That is the meaning. In divya, is there a dvitvam? Yes, there is a dvitvam in divya. See, dvitvam, many places, even without our knowledge, without actually identifying, we will be chanting it the way we pronounce the words. In some places, we will have to specifically point out so that we don't miss out on the dvitvam. Ninadaihi kakubho vihangaha. I hope that is clear. But when the visarga is followed by ka, we get a jihvamuliya. So that is the pronunciation. Ninadaih kakubho vihangaha. I hope that's clear. Anyway, if there are any questions which I have not answered, I think I've answered most of the questions today. If there are any questions which I have not answered, please send me an email and I will reply within a few days. So tomorrow we will complete learning Suprabhatam, the last two verses. And let us see, time permitting, we might begin Stotram. Otherwise, you all can raise your hands and we can have maybe individual chanting session tomorrow. If there is time after that, then we can move on to Stotram. Otherwise, day after we will move to Stotram. So please practice and we can have individual chanting tomorrow. We will conclude with Shanti Mantraha. Some of you have asked for Shanti Mantraha. So I've put it up on a slide. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramayah, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kashchid dukha bhag bhavet. Om shanti shanti shantihi. Sarvebhyah dhanyavadah. Thank you very much for joining today. Thank you to our panelists. We will meet tomorrow at the same time. That is 5:45 a.m. IST. Thank you all very much. Meet you tomorrow.